Hello everyone, my name is Adam and today I'll show you a project I've been working on for a few months.
And no, it won't be a multiplayer fighting arena game that I burn out on and realize it requires too much work for a first time.
I hate writing servers.
And attenzione, attenzione, this will not be a strategic web game that makes absolutely no sense. I briefly mentioned why these projects were abandoned, but maybe someday I'll expand on that. The game I'm creating involves navigating levels while avoiding various obstacles. The storyline revolves around a boy whose family member fell ill with cancer. He sets out on a journey to find a cure and uncover the secrets behind the research on mysterious crystals conducted by his father. I decided to go with pixel art graphics because I have a sentimental attachment to it. Titles like Mario, Metal Slug or Contra come to mind. Placing individual pixels brings me more joy than working on high resolution graphics. I am not particularly good at drawing, but I try my best to make it look good. That's why I'm showing it to you. I'm interested in your honest opinion. Friends said they like it, but they're just friends. It's like asking your mom about your look. She will never tell you that you're ugly.
Well, unless she doesn't love you.
Anyway, you know what I mean.
Moving in the game is simple. You can run, jump and dash. I aimed for the game to be dynamic and responsive. That's why the hero runs fast and there's quite a bit of gravity. Not much will change here, although I feel like I might need to weaken the dash. In the current setup, with a jump you can cover a large distance, perhaps too large. Players can't have it too easy. So, before I start creating levels, I need to finalize the parameters for the hero's movement. Regarding the level building, I use a grid. Each layer has a separate tilemap with different properties. For example, the ground layer collides with the player in terms of movement. In the trap layer, everything the hero touches kills him, and so on. To place tiles on the grid, I use rule tiles. Based on the neighborhood, it selects a tile to use. It randomly chooses one of the available tiles to avoid repetition. This way, I can quickly draw a level without thinking about which tile to use to make it fit. I just need to repair everything beforehand. You know, I'm quite the clever one. Nah, just kidding. Anyway, the background consists of layers with parallax movement script. Each layer has a different value that scales how much the background moves with the camera. Another aspect of the game is the mechanic I call selectors. These are objects marked with a wireframe. For example, signs, levers or buttons. The players can use actions while within the selector's range. Displaying a sign is an example of use. I plan to use selectors for other things as well. I've been thinking about mechanics for boss fights. For instance, using them to activate some cannons or temporarily extend a shield under which you can hide. In the game, there will also be collectibles. They are lab notes. They will contain story context. However, completing the game will not require collecting them. At any point in the game, you can take out the notes and read their contents. I've implemented dialogues in the game. I use localization tables to easily add dialogues in any language. All the texts included in the game also use this. As for the dialogue itself, the algorithm reads the person and then the text sequentially. Text boxes are created dynamically and adjusted to the text length. The text length varies depending on the language. The algorithm runs upon scene loading and every language change. Moving on, I managed to finish the menu, although there will be probably some changes. Certainly there will be a logo if I can finally come up with a name for the game. It's harder than I thought. Almost as difficult as, I don't know, eating the dinner I'll cook. Recently I accidentally found a build from early stages of creating the game. I have to admit that I'm pleased with how the game is growing and looking better. It requires a lot of work and time, considering that as one person I handle programming, creating graphics and the storyline. And now I even record a video about it. And that's not all, because there is still the matter of sound and music. In the future I will definitely use ready-made assets, but concerning this game, I've set a goal for myself to do it all from A to Z independently. Naturally, I'm pleased with the knowledge this brings me. Someone once told me that it's worth knowing everything about something and something about everything. And in my opinion, that's true. It's also worth mentioning the creators of tutorials that make learning certain things much easier. They often share their content for free. Hats off to them. As for me, I mainly use materials from creators like Adam Cianis, Brakis, and Code Monkey. Of course, there are many more. Thank you all for what you do. Stay awesome. That's all. This is my first video that I am uploading. I hope you enjoy it. If yes, leave a like and subscribe the channel. I'd also like to invite you to my Discord server where demo versions will be soon available for testing. If you have any ideas, want to chat or show off your own work, it's the right place. See you in the next video.